Yeah, hello and welcome to the online learning session ABB Free at Home Overview and Installation. Our online learning session takes around 30 minutes, maybe some minutes more today, and the focus is always on a special topic. But today we go back to the basics of Free at Home a bit. So the main part will be overview of the products and also installation. Yeah, my name is Thorsten Reibel from the ABB Competence Center Europe Smart Buildings, and together with us is Martin Vichari, and he will present today this topic. As always, you get the feedback email together with a recording of this session, so we record as always, and so the session as a presentation and also the video will be sent to you, but still today I will send you at least a PDF file of this session. Good, then I would hand over to Martin and he will continue. Just a moment.
Yeah, hello everyone also from my side, and thank you Thorsten for the introduction. As Thorsten already mentioned, today is the first online learning session where we cover or where we talk about the topic Free at Home. So what is on our agenda? As we already heard, we want to start really with the basics of Free at Home. So we want to give you an overview about what is Free at Home, of course, and what is the portfolio about, so which devices are available, and in the end also which kind or which different types or ways of installing the system we have. So here we are quite flexible and have different possibilities to install the system. But first of all, I want to start with a general introduction about Free at Home. So what is the system and what are the main benefits of the system? So ABB Free at Home is an easy to use home automation system. So also like KNX, we have here a system for a home automation, especially for the residential segment. And we also have here the main applications which are relevant in a residential in the residential area, which are lighting, blinds, heating, ventilation and air conditioning, and we also have the possibility to add our door communication system from ABB, the welcome system, to Free at Home. So this is first of all what Free at Home mainly is, so easy to use home automation system, and this is also the core aspect of Free at Home, the easiness of the system. So what are the three main aspects of Free at Home? So first of all, connected. Connected means we have a connected system, so all different applications, lights, HVAC, door communication, can be controlled with Free at Home, so can be controlled with one system, and means also can be controlled with the same switches, with voice control, with one Free at Home app, or also of course with your tablet or PC. So all different applications which are in general available in your private application are connected here. Easy means of course easy and flexible installation and operation. We have the possibility to use wired and wireless sensors, and of course also the actuators can be installed in different ways. So we have a centralized and a decentralized way to install the systems, and this we will see later in detail how this looks like. So this easiness is of course also important when we talk about the target group of Free at Home. So here we have a system which is not only interesting for a system integrator like in KNX, where the system integrator has to do the KNX basic and maybe advanced course. Here we also target really the electrical installer who has maybe no knowledge in KNX programming, but due to the fact that the system is so easy and that it's so easy to learn how to commission the system, that is also interesting for the electrical installer. And this is also the point, the third point, intuitive. So the configuration is very easy, can be done by the electrical installer, can be done via an app or via the PC, so both is possible now. And also for the end customer, it's quite easy to do some changes, to add some functions, to adjust the time programs, and so on. And here we come also to the main advantages of the system. So the most important main advantage of Free at Home is definitely that it's so user-friendly. So not only for the commissioner who set up the system, but also really for the end customer, it's quite easy to do some changes, to add functions or to change some of the functions which are maybe set to a sensor, or to add time programs and so on. Then we have, of course, a lot of possibilities with Free at Home. So not only the main applications like lights, heating, blinds, and so on are available. We also have the possibilities to add third-party systems. We can program different scenes, groups, and so on. So here we have a lot of possibilities also with our actions. So the logic functions gives us a lot of possibilities to create some comfort functions for the end user. Yeah, and last, of course, free and flexible. Free and flexible means here we are very flexible in installation. So this, as I said, we will see later on. We can select a centralized, a decentralized installation, or also maybe a mix of both ways. And of course, also important is always the shape of the sensors, so the colors and the shapes, the materials. Here we can choose between the whole ranges from ABB. So this is, of course, also important and available. So the main applications, as we said, lighting, blinds, HVAC, door communication, and also safety functions are available. And here we really want to show you today the whole portfolio, what is available, which devices are available, and how or which devices we can combine and how. We decided to show you this overview today also because in the last years, since we launched Free at Home, a lot of new devices, new functions, new features were added. So each year we have new firmware updates which bring new new features, new functions. We released new devices. So in the last years the system really were extended continuously. And so today we want to give you an overview about the situation and about the devices which are available today. Okay, so let's start now with an overview about the portfolio of Free at Home. So in general, we can first of all say that we can separate the portfolio into four different parts. We have first of all, of course, the system devices, so the devices which are always necessary when we want to use Free at Home. We have then the wired sensors, so all sensors which are used or which are connected directly to the bus cable with the Free at Home system. Then we have the wireless sensors, so we don't have to use the wired sensors. We can also use the wireless sensors, or we can also mix both of them. This is also both possible. And last, we have, of course, some DIN-rail components and some additional inputs, which are also available in the portfolio. First, the system devices. Here we have, of course, first of all, the system access point. Here, the system access point 2.0, so our newest version of the system access point, and more or less the heart of the system. So really, the most important device. Why it's so important? First of all, we need it, of course, for commissioning. So when we want to start to commission the whole system, then we have to connect our PC, our laptop, or our tablet, or our mobile phone with the system access point, and there we have the possibility to commission the system. Then we need the system access point for remote control, means later on when the end user wants to control his house also remotely, then he also needs the system access point with an MyBusjäger account, so with the remote control service activated. And of course, also from hardware point of view, we have some important features here. So we have here for the system access point the integrated wireless network, wireless antenna, so the interface for our wireless devices. We have, of course, the integrated Free at Home bus connection. And yeah, so this is, of course, first of all, from hardware point of view. And then we also have some additional functions here included, like the Astro functionality, time programs, and so on. Powered is the system access point via a 24-volt power supply. So here we can use an external plug. For example, when you have a renovation and you want to use wireless devices, then you can just simply use a power plug to power the system access point, or you can also use 24-volt via the two wires of the bus cable, the yellow and the white cable, to power the device, to power the system access point. When we have a wired system, so when you use bus cable to set up your free at home system, then you need of course also a power supply. So here the second system device which we need, if you have a wired installation, one power supply is enough to power around 70 to 75 devices from free at home. All in all, we can cover up to 150 devices, means if you have a project where you have more than 70 or 75 devices roundabout, then you need a second power supply. But if you have a wireless system, then you of course don't need the power supply, then this is only for the bus voltage. Okay, so let's start now with the wired sensors. So all devices which are more or less available to send some signals to the free at home system. And we start here, first of all, with our panels. So we have today four different panels for free at home available. First of all, the ABB Free at Home Touch 7. So this was also the first panel which was available for Free at Home. Here we can control up to 16 Free at Home functions. And this panel acts as a gateway between Free at Home and ABB Welcome. So our door communication with two-wire technology. So if you have a private project where you use ABB Welcome with the two-wire technology, then the ABB Touch 7 is the gateway between Free at Home and ABB Welcome. Then we have the ABB Touch 4.3-inch panel, so a little bit smaller, panel, but also with up to 16 free at home functions. So here we have up to four pages with four functions per page. This is really a pure free at home panel, so no connection to our welcome system, no connection to an IP system or something like this. So this is really a pure free at home panel. And the newest devices in this family are the ABB Touch 7-inch and the ABB Touch 10-inch panel. So comes from our family of the Welcome IP portfolio. And here we can control up to 64 functions for the 7-inch panel and up to 100 functions for the 10-inch panel. And here, important, this is now the gateway between Free at Home and our Welcome IP system. So if you have a project where you use Welcome IP and Free at Home in the same project, or when you want to connect both systems, then you have to select one of these panels here. For the panels, we of course have some additional equipment also available. So you need the mounting boxes for the panels. So here, for example, the flush mounted box for the 4.3-inch panel, which you always need. And for the 4.3-inch free at home panel, you also have the possibility to add an additional temperature sensor to the panel. Good, so now our sensor units. So first of all, we have two sensor units available in general. So a one-gang version and a two-gang version. Both devices are available to send commands, so switching, dimming, blind commands, to the ABB Free at Home system. So to the system access point, or we can say to an actuator to to switch on a light, for example, or to drive the blind up or down. So this is really only a command sender here, and both devices and all the following devices which we will show on the next slide can be used as a one-gang rocker or as a two-gang push button control element. So here you can select in the configuration if this is really a one gang control element, means for example on the top side you switch a light on and on the bottom side you switch the light off, or you select or you configure this one as a two gang control element, then you can switch the light on and off on the top top side of the sensor, and on the bottom side of the sensor you can switch a second light, for example, on and off. The same for the two gang sensor, so here you can select between a two gang rocker more or less or a four gang push push button control element. Then we have some combination devices in our portfolio, so the sensor switch actuator devices. So means here we don't, or here we not only have a sensor available to send some commands, here we have integrated in these devices also a switch actuator. Three different versions are available, 1/1 gang, 2/1 gang and 2/2 gang. Means here we have one control element and one actuator. For the second one we have two control elements, so left side and right side, and one switching actuator. And with the third version we have two control elements and two actuators integrated in this sensor switch actuator here. So these are combination devices, so not only a command sender more or less. Here you also really have the actuator which switches on a light on and off directly integrated inside the device. This is not only available for switching, this is also available for dimming. For dimming we have the versions 1/1 gang and 2/1 gang, so only one dimming actuator integrated here in the device, but also with one or two sides to control or to send commands. The same also for the blind actuator, here again 1/1 gang or 2/1 gang to control blinds or the motor of some blinds. And we also have the same versions or also available are the movement detectors here in both variants. So one movement detector only as a sensor, so this device only detects some movement and sends a switching command, for example, depending on the brightness, and the same device also available with integrated switch actuator. So here we have different devices available and you can select depending on your installation which one you need. Where we need which device we will see in the end of the session today. Then the last sensors we have in the portfolio is one room thermostat. So first of all here the room thermostat to send, for example, a set point to a heating actuator or to control some valves. So here you mainly just set up the set temperature, or you activate the echo mode, or you can also select the fan speed, for example. So this is again only a sender of some commands to the system, and the same also for the weather station. So here you can record and send weather data, so like the wind speed, the brightness from outside to the system, and again you can create some logic here, like when the wind is too strong, please drive the blinds up so that you don't get a damage on your with your blinds. So then we have all the sensors which you saw now available as a wired sensor, also available as wireless sensors. So you will see now that we have here more or less the same devices available as wireless with some differences. First of all, again, the sensor unit 1-gang as wireless and 2-gang as wireless version. So again, only really only a sensor, so only sending commands like switching, dimming, blinds and so on to the free-at-home system or to the free-at-home actuator. Available as 1-gang and as 2-gang. Then the same in the combination with a sensor and a switching actuator on the backside. So here also three different types available, 1/1 gang, 2/1 gang and 2/2 gang. For all the devices which have an actuator on the backside, we also have one extension unit input available. Means if we have, for example, a renovation project and you have a room where you want to switch the light from two spots in the room and you have two conventional switches integrated or installed, then you only have to change one of the conventional switch, you install the Free at Home switch, and you can use the extension unit input to use the conventional switch also to switch on the light and on and off in this room. And this extension unit input is available for all the wireless devices which has an actuator integrated. So then the sensor dimming actuator devices. So here again, 1/1 gang, so one rocker, one actuator, or two control elements and one actuator integrated. Same also for the blind actuator. So here, as you see, the same devices like in the wired version, but as wireless device. For the movement detector, we only have here for as wireless device the version available with actuator. So we don't have a movement detector wireless, which has only or which acts only as sensor. Here we always have the actuator integrated, because this is the most common case when you have renovation and you want to use the wireless movement detector here. For the room thermostats, we have here now two versions available. One, again, only as a sensor, so only to send commands to the system, for example, to a radiator, to send the set point, for example. And we also have a room thermostat with integrated heating actuator so that you can connect directly, for example, your electric floor heating system here to the room thermostat. These are the two radiator thermostats which are available. So we have one basic version without displays. So here you definitely need, for example, one sensor which sends the set point to the radiator. This can be, for example, the thermostat we saw on the last slide, or for example, also the Free at Home app can be used to do this, but we have no direct possibility to control or to adjust the set point here on the device. This possibility we have with the comfort version. So here we have this little rotary knob available. So here you can also adjust the set point directly on the thermostat. Then we have two more wireless sensors, which are here also battery driven like the thermostats, which are the window sensor and the universal detector. So the window sensor can show the current window handle position, so you really see if the window is open, closed, or tilted. And we have then one universal detector, so if you have, for example, some doors with some special shapes where you don't can't use the normal window sensor, then you also have the universal detector, which just show you the status open or closed. And the last device, especially for our wireless portfolio, is the external antenna. So in the case when the system access point is installed somewhere where it's shielded, for example in a metal housing or something like this, then you can use the external antenna to strengthen the wireless signal for the system access point. So and last, of course, we have to mount then our sensors, which we just saw here. We have all the standard design ranges available. So here, first of all, the mounting for the VDE version. So in general, we can say we need always one sensor insert, one rocker, and one cover frame. And in the end, you can decide then which standard which design range you want to use. So here we have the ranges available: Karat, Dynasty, Accent, Solo, Stainless Steel, and Future Linear. So this is for the VDE range. Of course, we have some further ranges available. For example, Zenit NEMA, Zenit VDE, Millennium, and Milus. So here we have the same sensors or the same inserts with the same functionality also available in this ranges. Good, and the last part of the components here are the DeanRail components and the inputs. So here we also want to give you a short overview about what is available. We start first of all with the switching actuators. Here we have two different types. One quite, one simple switching actuator with four channels, where you have also the possibility for manual operation directly here on the device. And we have one switching actuator with eight outputs, and this is again a combination device. Here we have not only eight outputs for switching channels, here we also have at the same time eight binary inputs which you can use. So for example, when you want to add some conventional switches to the Free at Home installation, or maybe some signals from a window contact or whatever, then you have here a good combination device where you have directly both functions, so a switching actuator and binary input integrated. Then we don't only want to switch lights, we can also dim lights. Here again, two different versions available, four outputs and six outputs, and optimize for dimming retrofit LED lamps. So here also two different versions, depending on your needs, you can select which one you select. And the last device to control some lights is the DALI gateway, so one of our newest devices in the Free at Home portfolio. Here you can connect up to 60 DALI slaves or DALI lights to this actuator. Next week in our online learning session, we will focus a little bit more on the DALI gateway, which functions are available here. So if you're interested, then you can register also for the online learning session next week. Yeah, the blind actuator, I think this is also clear. So here with four outputs, so to control four independent blinds or shutters, for example. Very important, of course, also the heating actuator, 12 gang or 6 gang, so to control some floor heatings, for example, or some valves of the floor heating system. Here again, depending on your needs, depending on the size of your project, you can select between a 12 gang and a 6 gang version. And last, from actuator side here, the fan coil actuator, so for controlling blower convectors, here 2-pipe or 4-pipe systems are supported, and also fan speed devices can be controlled with this actuator. Then also very new in our portfolio is the split unit gateway, so to control the air conditioning system's split units. So here again we will talk about this device in detail next week, so if you're interested, then you can register and join us also next week, where we will discuss in detail the split unit gateway. So last but not least, so also very important, are the binary inputs. So here one DeanRail component with four inputs, so four binary inputs in the, for this device. And we also have two pills available, which can be installed somewhere maybe directly next to a window or a door, and where you have two channels and four channels available. Also quite new in the Free at Home family is the alarm stick. So this can be used to integrate smoke, heat, and carbon monoxide detectors. So the devices which you know from the ABB portfolio can be integrated now directly into the Free at Home system with this alarm stick. So you don't have to create a solution with some binary inputs and some relays or something like this. Now the devices can be directly integrated into the system with the alarm stick. Brings also the benefit that you see really in detail where you have maybe an alarm or which battery of which device is maybe low. Good, and the really last part of the portfolio is of course also the app. So as many of you maybe know, is we have a new app since this year's, with new and modern design, of course, but also with some new features. So it's now possible also to configure the whole system with the app, so also with your mobile phone. In the past it was only possible with a tablet or of course with a PC and laptop. Now you can also configure and do some changes directly with the app. And of course we would still recommend to do the first commissioning of the whole system with the PC, because it's a little bit more easy to see the whole system and create all the rooms and so on. But if you have some smaller changes in your house, in your apartment, then it's now also possible to do this changes with our new Free at Home Next app. Good, so this was already the whole portfolio. Last topic for today is the installation. So you saw already that we have different types of devices available and we have different possibilities how to install them. You saw that we have two different kind of actuators in the system. On the one hand, we have the sensor actuator combination devices and we have the pure sensors in our system. This brings us also to the two different types of installing a Free at Home system. We have here on the left side a decentralized installation and on the right side a centralized installation. Decentralized means in this case that the actuators, so the devices which are really controlling the motor, for example, of a blind or also switching the light on and off, are directly installed next to the consumer more or less. So they are installed or they are available inside the sensor, so on the back side of the sensor more or less, and here you connect the motor of a blind, for example, directly to the actuator here, which is installed behind the sensor. Means the actuators are installed decentralized everywhere in the house, next to the light, next to the blind, and so on. Centralized means we have all the actuators directly, or all the actuators centrally installed in the cabinet, for example. And this also means that all the wires to the motor of a blind, for example, goes from the cabinet to the blinds directly. So here we don't have a direct connection from the sensor to the blinds with the 230 volt, for example. Here we really have the normal wiring. This is of course, so the decentralized version is of course a little bit more flexible and easy for when it comes to wiring. On the right side, the centralized installation brings us of course a little bit more more cost efficient solution. If we have a look at in detail how a centralized topology could look like, so here, as we said, we only really have the sensors available, so only command sensors, and the sensors are also only powered via the Free at Home bus. So this is then enough. The sensors don't need 230 volt, they only need the voltage from the Free at Home bus. And then we are sending the commands to the system access point or to the actuators, and the actuators are, the outputs are now directly connected to the different lights in my house, for example. In the second version, the decentralized topology, we really have to power all, or we have to bring also the 230 volt to each sensor, because the actuator is installed behind the sensor, and here we just power then we power the lights not from the cabinet, we power them from the sensor actuator combination. This can be of course also be mixed, so you don't have to use an only centralized or only decentralized installation. You can also mix this depending on your needs. And what else is of course possible, we saw not only devices for a centralized or decentralized installation. We saw we also have wireless devices, and also these components can be mixed. So you can say I want to add first of all some basic functions as wired devices, and maybe in 2 or 3 years you can add some wireless devices also to the installation. Here you just have to make sure that you install enough sensors to create really a mesh network that the commands really reach the system access point. So we recommend here to install one sensor for each room on one floor, for example, that you really have a guarantee that the signals will reach the system access point. Good, and last slide for today. So the connection for all the sensors. So what do we need? We already heard some points of it. So the sensor unit wired, one gang and two gang, really only need the bus voltage. So very easy to wire them. You only need the bus voltage to wire them. If you have the wireless sensors, doesn't matter if you have only the sensor, or like you see here on the right side, the sensor and switch actuator combination, then you always need 230 volts, so always live and neutral. For the version with the actuators integrated, you also have here the extension unit input to get also the signal from a conventional switch directly here into the sensor. If you use the sensor switch actuator combinations wired, then you of course need the bus voltage and you also need 230 volt to power the actuator or to give the to switch on and off the light, for example. Good, so I'm a little bit over time, but I think we are now finished with all the information, so I can hand back to Thorsten.
Yeah, thanks, Martin. In my opinion, Free at Home is now a real, complete system for home automation, covering most of the applications. And thanks to connection to third-party solutions, we come to this in the next sessions. In a few minutes, I will explain what will be the next. Getting more and more complete. Easy installation, but also easy commissioning is a big topic. And you've seen one slide with the app where you can not only can operate easily, but also change any functions. This can be done by the end user easily. Good, then allow me to go to the typical final slides and the preview of our next activities. What we are going to do in the next time, still this year at least. So of course, everything is on internet for ABB Free at Home. So there is a big homepage, let's say, with all the information and also downloads you need. I've given you here the link in this presentation as well. And in our training qualification database, we store all our sessions like this today, both as video but also as a presentation file. In our calendar at the moment, only online sessions, webinars and online learning sessions. No presence trainings at the moment in the factories possible, and neither for our certified trainings, but we are planning, of course, for the next year, and we will see when we can start this real classroom or presence training. We will inform you. So what is planned next? Next week we continue with our webinar. Next webinar also dealing with ABB Free at Home, interfacing with third-party systems via local API. API is a application programming interface, a software interface to integrate other solutions. We are working with this already, and we have already some existing solutions. Martin will explain what's behind, and everything around API, application programming interface, as a webinar, so 1 hour, but still this week on Thursday we continue also with Free at Home, the third party integration, what is already existing as complete solutions. In addition to this, what you have seen already as a basic functions, and as already also mentioned by Martin on the 15th of December, we have another online learning session about the DALI and split unit gateway. Today only I mentioned very fast, but there's something more behind us to explain this a bit more detailed. And this will be also then the online learning session on Thursday the 15th. Of course, more will come next year. We are really working on our plan for next year, and we will inform you. So, no questions at the moment. Then I say thank you for your participation. Hope to see you next time. Bye-bye. Ciao.